No, and thank goodness we don't. That man, I would give that man such a hard time. I would make that man sweat bullets. Okay, my husband has a hard time keeping up with me emotionally, as it is, but in the ways that count, he gets me. When I feel like it's a yellow day and I wear all yellow, he understands the reasoning behind it. You know, he's willing to look things up and find out the whens and the whys and the hows instead of just going with what everyone traditionally says that you should. He gets me in the way that is important to me and vice versa. That man would never get me. I would give that man such thrills. He's happily married with two children, and I wish him all the best with his life, and I am happy with mine. Day, believe it or not, when I wake up in the morning, before I even get out of bed, I say today is going to be a good day. I cannot control anything that's going to go on, but I will control my reactions and I'm going to will it to be a good day in spite of. No broken bones, but it's just as bad because when I had my first child, my OBGYN, she sewed me up, and 20 minutes later, I told her that those stitches had popped. She didn't believe me, so at my post visit, she saw that yes, it did pop. And in fact, I was developing an infection, so she had to go in there, light a match, and burned me down there. Yes, burned me 2 to 3 times, and it was searing, searing pain. My first movies didn't really impress me that much, but I do remember seeing my first Blue movie, and it was when I was around 17, and I was in a hotel in Florida with my family, and they had left because you know I don't like to go anywhere. And I was lying down, relaxing my body. I switched on the cable, and there popped up this Blue movie. I was like, oh my Lord. So this is what goes on behind closed doors. This is what it's all about. And my imagination just kept going. After that, you couldn't tell me a thing. I have never been to a foreign country, but I was slotted to go at some point to the Middle East to teach reading. But then I met my husband and I changed all my plans. But because my husband and my children, they love to travel, I've been all over the US of A. But I am planning to go to fly to some part of Africa or Europe come next year. So that's on my agenda. See, I'm trying. I don't like this traveling nonsense, but I do it. You see, I'm putting myself out there. I got in trouble for the dumbest, most foolish thing, which is laughing. Don't ask me what was so funny day in and day out in that class, but everything made me laugh, or I made a joke about something. And I would laugh, not just laugh, but laugh uncontrollably. And then my teacher would have to say, Leslianne, go out into the yard and face the tree. So I would be facing that tree 10, 15 minutes, and then when she thought it was time to come back in, she'd tell me, come in, I'd sit down, and I'd start laughing again, and then have to go out and stand up by that tree. I started with the tame stuff like manischewitz, the Concord grape. I love that stuff. Oh my goodness, I love it. But then I graduated to Long Island iced teas, and my husband really thought that I was pretending, like making a joke. But once that hit my system, I start to dance and, you know, wind up myself and make myself free. And he's looking at me like, who's this person? And he really didn't believe it. That was when we were dating. And after that, he knew not to give me a drink because when we went down to take the train, you know, I almost teetered off the platform, and he saw, no, I really wasn't joking. Who's going to want a roommate with me? Nobody's gonna want a roommate with me. When I get ready, I put on my country music, then my Bollywood music. old-timey music, and I have to be free in the buff and all that sort of stuff. And that's from since I am very young. Things are uncontrollable in this world, nature, everything, but it's the way that you choose to react to something that is what will determine whether you're happy or sad for a long, 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 long time. So if I could just control my emotions, it would be so much better emotionally, health-wise for my body, my family would benefit from it. You know, the ball just keeps rolling. My wish is still to swim. Yes, I took my lessons this summer, but I am like this. I have to be in control of every last atom in my body. So I have to learn to like let go. I need more lessons. It just didn't go. But I did learn how to ride a bike thanks to my hubby. Lessons were music lessons, and they were horrible. I was about 8 years old, and every time I made a mistake on the piano, the instructor, she would take a long, thin, I guess like that conductor stick, and she would wrap me on my knuckles. So could you imagine, you're trying, but it's like Pavlov's dogs. Now I'm conditioned, and I'm like, so ever since then, I just... My first job was at Burger King. That's now closed down. It was 6 years ago, I believe, right at this stretch where Kings Plaza Mall is. And I was 16 and it was summer, and I was hoping that they would give me a full-time position come fall, and the manager was going to give it to me. Except that I had to close one night, and my parents were like, what? 12 o'clock you're closing? Oh, no, 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 no. And the manager said, yes, she has to do it. And after that, they said, no, you have to shut that job down. You can't do it. So I only got enough money to give to my grandma on my mother's side for whatever she needed. But she called me and told me she needed money. So I gave it to her. But that was my first experience. And I was so annoyed that I couldn't get that full-time position in the fall. I was feeling like such a big girl, you know? I don't have any piercings or tattoos. I don't feel that I know enough about piercings and tattoos to put that all over my body. I would feel like imprisoned by it because I don't know enough about them. I wish I could still keep in touch with my best friend from high school, which is MJ. She still has a special place in my heart. She doesn't speak to me anymore. To me, she's still the way that we were when we were in high school. No, I shouldn't say that. It's just that we're at different points in our lives. I don't know for now, but I know at least 8 years ago, she was still single with no children and was focused on taking care of her younger sister and her career and her mother's property, as far as I know. So we went and totally different directions. I don't remember any of my teachers. It was all a very painful blur, and I'm just grateful that it's over. But when I was in high school in the States, I had this one Jewish, gay, short little lady teacher, and she was very, very nice to me. She made me feel so valued in little ways, but she would always tell me, you know, Leslie Ann, you're so beautiful inside and out, you know. And she would look into my eyes, you know, like she really, really meant it. And it It's simple. It seems simple to you, but it did something for me. It made me feel very valued. First wedding that I attended was my mother's. I was 5 years old at the time. She's been married to my father for 30 or 35 years now. Cars and I are not friends. I have a Durango in the driveway and it's been there for the past 7 years and I have not driven it. Yes, the battery is dead. How am I going to make this the best day for myself so that I don't have a lot of hassles and I can make it smooth for myself and others? I am in control of how I react to something. Let's go, let's keep it moving. That is my motto, and this is not something that I'm just saying right now. Most of the time, when people on my job, they're talking to me. The last thing they'll say is, okay, let's keep it moving because they know that's how I am. You talk to me and you tell me all your problems. Okay, but now let's see how we can solve it. Well, this is how I am in the morning. What am I going to do today? How am I going to accomplish it and make it the best that I can make it for myself and everybody else? First ever concert was to see Ashanti, you know. Da-na-na-na-da-da-da. But the only thing is that I can't understand why does she always go like this? And that's every dance that you see her do. She's always doing. But I love her. She's lovely voice, lovely lady to look at. This tag was from the Bronze Goddess, and I tag you. Okay, luck lovers, until next time, bye.